ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back. I have quite a lot to talk about for this video, so I guess let's get to it. Well, according to a new report that's recently been put out, due to Donald Trump making the decision to withdraw from the Iranian nuclear deal, many oil-importing countries will possibly be left without their key supplier. Maybe a better way to state it, as someone I'm friends with on Facebook said on May 8th, quote-unquote, gas going to $5 a gallon without Iranian oil, say goodbye to the House and Senate, repubs. In other words, them stating the belief that without Iranian oil, that gasoline prices here in the United States could possibly hit $5 a gallon. And the person saying, if that should happen, that the Republicans might as well not even campaign come the midterms, because it would be guaranteed that they would lose. One of Donald Trump's accusers, Rachel Crooks, has won her Ohio state legislature primary. Now, she has indicated she decided to run in part because of her running with Trump. Basically, she has stated that being sexually harassed by Trump inspired her to run for public office. Now, she won her race on Tuesday, May the 9th. She ran unopposed and will now face Republican State Representative Bill Reinecke, I don't know if I'm getting his name right, in November during this year's midterms. Now, while the district that Crooks hopes to represent leans red, if Crooks wins, she would become the first Trump accuser to hold elected public office. Now, I've been talking about this quite a bit with certain members of my family as of lately. The thing is, suffice to say, Donald Trump's win in a rigged presidential election 2 years ago in 2016 may turn out to be the last stand, maybe even the final desperate power grab of the Republican Party. Since once Trump goes down at the conclusion of the Russia investigation for collusion and treason, he's bound to take most, if not the majority, of the party down with him. Now, best case scenario for the Republican Party is that Trump takes down most of the party with him when the Russia investigation takes him down. Worst case scenario is that almost all the party gets taken down with Trump when the Russia investigation takes him down. Now, the thing is, when the Russia investigation takes Trump down, Trump himself would likely face the loss of his personal fortune, which is currently valued at about $3.1 billion, and his business empire, the Trump Organization, as well as his family, meaning his wife, Melania, his sons, Eric, Donald Jr., and Barron, and his daughters, Ivanka and Tiffany, turning on him once they realize he only cares about himself. And finally, NBC completely and fully terminating its connection to Trump by canceling The Apprentice franchise, as in more or less pulling from its network any further involvement with The Apprentice. Though right now it's more or less unknown what the network could replace Trump's show with if they eventually choose to pull the Apprentice franchise from their network. Now, something that I've seen as of lately is that some Trump supporters are now starting to realize what Trump's actions may do to their business, such as Trump's stance on immigration that could end up greatly hurting those supporters of his who run businesses. The fact of the matter being that many Trump supporters are now showing regret towards having voted for him, as his policies could drive some of them, at least the ones who own and run businesses, to corporate bankruptcy, not just because of Trump's stance on immigration, but his thing of giving tax cuts to the rich. Now, switching over to something not so much affecting us here in the States, but one of our allies overseas, you know, in the United Kingdom, apparently every political party in Scotland, except for the Tories, has voted for Scotland to not give its consent for the United Kingdom's planned European Union withdrawal bill, setting up a possible British constitutional crisis, as of course Great Britain is, I believe, currently a constitutional monarchy. Now, of course, as has been the case since the Brexit referendum, since that was put to a vote, some have been saying that if the United Kingdom's withdrawal goes through, it could result in Scotland soon afterwards pushing for its own independence referendum. Meaning that if the UK completes its withdrawal from the European Union, it would result in Scotland pushing for its own independence referendum to happen. Now, such a situation would result in the British Parliament at that point having either of two choices. The first choice would be the British Parliament willingly recognizing / acknowledging Scotland's independence desire, allowing them to break away from the UK, which would then result in Scotland rejoining the European Union as a newly independent nation. Choice number two is the British Parliament refusing to recognize / acknowledge Scotland's independence desires. That would result in the possibility of a British civil war breaking out between England and Scotland. Now, the reason why I did not include Wales in that is because, well, England annexed Wales, I forget how many centuries or whatever ago. Now, such a civil war between England and Scotland could possibly see Northern Ireland allying with Scotland in an effort to eventually bolster the chances of its own independence from the United Kingdom. Now, should Scotland eventually succeed in its actions and the UK is willing to let Scotland go through with independence, if it should be that Northern Ireland ends up deciding to eventually follow in the footsteps of Scotland and seek its own independence from the United Kingdom, that would open the path to an eventual reunification between Northern Ireland and the Republic of Ireland, after which a unified Irish island could possibly then seek to join the European Union. Now, I think at this point, from a lot of what I've seen on social media, particularly on Twitter, especially immediately after the Brexit referendum vote, I believe it can pretty much be said that the fact is, at least in the United Kingdom, that right-wing disinformation and deception, as well as those in the UK voting Leave, not really knowing what they were voting for, will eventually result in the complete dissolution of the United Kingdom. Because if the United Kingdom successfully completes its withdrawal from the European Union, as I just stated, that would then result in Scotland and Northern Ireland wanting to declare their independence from the United Kingdom. Now, should all this happen, it would then eventually render England, as well as Wales, retirement countries, as the youth of the United Kingdom would seek to break away from what seems to be in the minds of the Scots and the Irish, from their older, senile countrymen, and rejoin an alliance they were unfairly separated from by way of a vote that did not represent them or their beliefs and desires. Now, a recent news item that has come up is that, I stated in a previous video on this channel that Democrats were going to try to force the Senate to vote on a bill that would more or less void the Federal Communications Commission's rollback of net neutrality. Well, a news report that I saw today is that Democrats have succeeded in their effort to force the Senate to vote on a bill that would void the FCC's rollback of net neutrality. However, the problem with this situation, the trouble, is that the bill would face tremendous Republican opposition in the Republican-controlled House, not to mention opposition from Trump in the Oval Office. Now, of course, one thing to point out is that even if the bill to void the FCC's rollback of net neutrality gets defeated, Democrats are hoping to use it and net neutrality in general as a campaign issue in the up-and-coming midterm elections, attempting to convince voters to restore Democrats' control of Congress in order to restore net neutrality as well as rolling back quite a lot of what the Republican-controlled Congress has done since Republicans took control of Congress back in 2014 during the midterm elections. Well, with nothing really more to talk about for now, that's pretty much about it for this video blog entry. As always, I thank you for tuning in to my video blog, as well as watching this video. And so, until next time, as always, take care of yourselves and each other. Live every day to the fullest, and live your life the best that you possibly can. So, until next time, all that's left to say is, have a great day, everyone.